starting in District 23A.
The Jasper Bulldogs welcoming state powerhouse Carthage to the Alamo.
Out to the action we go, and it's the Terrence Cooney Show. Early on, it's Jasper would take an early 7-0 lead as he powers his way into the end zone for a 7-0 lead. Cooney would later score to make it 14-0, but Carthage came back in this football game, led by Tevin Pipkin, breaking it up the middle. Finally brought down outside the Jasper 20-yard line. As we go to the scoreboard, Jasper is only 21-20 at the half, but they win it 41-26.
Over at Anahuac, they were taking on the number 2 state-ranked Newton Eagles. Anahuac came to play tonight, sitting at 3-1 in district play, just one game behind Newton. Passing the ball here to Byron Riggs, and he's down the sideline, and there he goes, in for the touchdown, cutting the lead down to 8. On the other end, though, they got a guy named Brandon Johnson who would have another huge night, and he's going to score on this, and he would score a couple of other times. Eagles, they win it tonight, big time, over Anahuac, 62-27.
Also in District 10-2A, it was the East Chambers Buccaneers traveling to Kuntz to take on the Lions, trying to break the 40-year drought in the playoffs. Pink out night in Kuntz, and East Chambers early on with Brandon Johnson. Play action fake, throwing deep, and he finds Aaron Sutherland, the coach's son. Diving catch, takes it away from the defender for a big gainer there. As we go to the scoreboard in this one, Johnson completing another pass, and we still have a late fourth quarter score. East Chambers trying to hang on, leading 31-25.
How about Woodville and Kirbyville out there in Wildcat Stadium, where Coach Neese's Wildcats, yeah, they're starting to play some good ball here. That pass out to Pat Beatty. He's in for the touchdown, 14-6 Wildcats at this point. This one was a nail biter, and the Wildcats of Kirbyville take it by 2 points. They win it 21-19. They move to 6-2 for the year, 4-1 in district play.
Louisville Pirates bouncing back after a loss at home to a couple weeks ago. Louisville winning last week and beating Hempville tonight, who's winless on the season, 0-7. Now 0-8 as Cody Dupuy breaks through with his touchdown run to make it 30-0 Pirates there in the third quarter. As we go to the scoreboard on this one, Louisville now 2-1 in district play, beating Hempville 45-6.
Over at Kelly, the Bulldogs desperate. Trying to end that losing streak. Nice national anthem there being sang at Bulldogs Stadium. The defense came to play there. Chris Falgu all over them. But St. Pius would start getting things going and getting in the end zone early and often. Go to the final. St. Pius, the Panthers. They pound the Bulldogs tonight 56-7. They are looking good in district play. Kelly still trying to get that first win.
How about some six-man action from Orange tonight? Community Christian, the Lions going up against Living Stones out of Alvin, who's 2-0 in district play. Community Christian at 1-1, and Living Stones taking the lead here, 20-7 on this run by the quarterback, diving for the end zone and the touchdown. It went back and forth in this one as we check the final. Living Stones outlast Community Christian, winning 56-53.
We've now hit our final timeout here on the Blitz. When we return, a check on the Allentown scoreboard.
But first, it's time for our Play of the Week.
5 Point Credit Union presents the Play of the Week.
And it's back to Jasper. It's Terrence Cooney. We talked about that other touchdown he had in the first quarter against Carthage. Well, here's the other touchdown. 95 yards by Terrence Cooney to give the Bulldogs a 14-0 lead over the Carthage Bulldogs. But once again,
it was so exciting,
Carthage
it blacked
came,
out the screen.
Yeah, Jasper fans didn't want to see the rest of it. They hung tough there for a while. They'll be ready for the playoffs, I'm sure, as we'll be back to wrap things up on the Blitz. So, final performance by the Band of the Week from Vider after this.